possible trailers that we might be seeing this weekend during the Super Bowl. Welcome back to another episode, nerds. I am Dustin. You might know me as Generally Nerdy, but this is where you get your pop culture, entertainment, and nerd news headlines once a week, right now, twice a week if you count the live show. But either way, this episode is huge. Honestly, we have probably the most optimistic rumor mill we've had in a long time. So stick around to the end of the video for the rumor mill. And then we have in TV streaming, we have a couple of promising trailers to talk about. We have a whole bunch of music to get out of the way, as well as an update on the Joe Rogan situation. NASA is taking us back to the moon. All kinds of exciting stuff. So before we can get into the exciting stuff, we do have a little bit of housekeeping to get out of the way. And that is that I misspoke at the beginning of the last episode. If you are watching the YouTube channel, then that means we are in season 4. Everything else is in season 2, save for the audio, the main audio outlet, which is in season 3. So yeah, that's where we are. But that's the only real housekeeping we have. So let's get into the shout outs section. This is a little bit larger than it has been in previous weeks, so we're just gonna breeze through this as quickly as possible. So starting things off, we are in Twitter shout outs are as follows. Thomas Harrigan at TH0093. Thank you very much, nerd, for the follow. And then Nick at NIXFLIX, NixFlix77. Thank you very much, nerd, for the follow. If you want your shout out from the Twitter, you have to follow me at generally_nerdy. And then our next set of shout outs is on the YouTube. We don't have any comment shout outs. I honestly just didn't have the time to grab the comment shout outs, so my apologies. We'll get to those next week. But we do have one new follower on the main channel, and that is melonman_rr. Thank you very much, nerd, for the follow. There are 2 YouTube channels. There's about to be 3 YouTube channels that you can follow for your shout out, and that is Generally Nerdy or Nerd News Clips, which is the shortened version of all of this information, plus all of the shorts, as well as coming soon, How To Content. You're going to be testing the waters there. So yes, that is what you can do for your shout out on the YouTubes. Also comment, that gets you a shout out on YouTube as well. So next is Instagram follows, shout outs. I mean, that is one on Instagram, Lewis_Bowley. Thank you very much, nerd, for the follow. Again, on the Instagrams, it is at Generally Nerdy or Facebook at Generally Nerdy. The page is facebook.com/Generally Nerdy, Generally Nerdy Gaming, or Generally Nerdy Photo. All of those will get you a shout out for this section. And then TikTok shout outs, huge as per usual. So we're just gonna get to this as quickly as possible. Gladiator_Bricks, very special shout out for contributing to today's episode. And then we have Your Dog Joey, Mystique101, BenKillsGod69, CrazyKid710, BenGaming2810, FreeFollow420.69, weird, RA1Shen, Ant3KA9, DerekThomas3183, StarPro6_9, The3rdDecade, ToneDog, Metric_XD, CoreyHartree4, UWU_Toast, The_Untheist0. Thank you very much, nerds, for the follow on TikToks. It's really easy, at Generally Nerdy. That's where I am. That's how you get your follows. That is the shout out section. And let's get into the news. Real quick, nerds, before we go any further, I just wanted to remind you that there is a merch store. So if you are unable to follow the Patreon or just want a real quick way to support the channel, this is a great way to do that. And then you can wear my merch all over the place. And it's pretty awesome merch, I'm not gonna lie. So go check it out over at the General Store on generallynerdy.net. Right across the top, there is a General Store tab, and that is where you can find all 3 of the merch stores. That being said, let's get back into the episode. So we're going to kick things off in music like we do. We do have some, no follows, we do have some new music to talk about. So real quick, first impressions on a couple of tracks. We have three tracks in the first impressions new music section, and that is Hailstorm is the first one. Hailstorm just released a new single called The Steeple from their new record, which is going to be called Back From The Dead. It is releasing May 6th. This new The Steeple track is underwhelming, but I kind of find most of Hailstorm's music to be a little underwhelming. Lizzie Hale is a rock and roll chick if I've ever seen one, and she can write a catchy tune, but it doesn't do a whole lot to keep my interest past like the first, second verse. Ish. And I don't know. Active rock, I guess, isn't my subgenre, if you will. So next we're going to be talking about the new one from Arch Enemy. Previously, we talked about their first single off of this new record, Deceiver, Deceiver, which was kind of underwhelming. This new track is called Handshake with Hell, also from the same record that is coming out July 29th, named Deceivers. This was definitely a step up. I do think this was a smart choice on their part to start the new record with this song. This one is legitimately interesting, vocally speaking. There is a lot more play with Alyssa, I think is how you're supposed to say her name. Alyssa Whiteglose. She's getting a little bit more experimental with the vocals on this one, and I appreciate that, but the song structure is very predictable, even if it is pretty good production-wise. It's just the songwriting is just, I can, verse, chorus, bridge, solo, verse, out. Like, it's you can see it coming a mile away. If you're a fan of Arch Enemy, you'll definitely dig this track. I'm not the hugest fan of Arch Enemy since Alyssa has become the vocalist. Didn't really do a whole lot for me. Can't really recommend it, but our final first impression for this episode is Red Hot Chili Peppers' new track. It is called, I apologize, Black Summer. I don't know how these guys have such a formulaic sound, but still keep it interesting. You know it's the Chili Peppers. Their song structures are not really anything crazy to write home about. Flea is probably one of the greatest bass players to have ever lived. John Frusciante is easily one of the most experimental guitar players to have ever lived. And Chad Smith just knows how to work between the two of them. And then Kiedis, I don't know what the hell Anthony Kiedis is doing, especially in this song with those weird pronunciations of the R's at the first half of the, I don't know, just guy Kiedis is kind of the one element of this band that I'm like, meh, I could do with or without Kiedis. He's a pretty solid vocalist, and also a pretty interesting lyricist, definitely a great lyricist back in the day. These days, I wouldn't necessarily go that far, but very interesting track. I can absolutely recommend this one, which is strange that the two heavy tracks this week were not really recommends, but the lighter track is whole on recommend this new Red Hot Chili Peppers track. Now we have some actual music news for this episode. First up, we're talking about Kirk Hammett. That's right, Metallica's guitar slinger himself is doing his first solo project. At least I'm pretty sure this is his first. I couldn't find any other examples of him doing a solo project. He's done guest spots and stuff like that, but him and Robert are known to kind of goof off between songs while they're on stage. To varying degrees of success. Either way, Kirk Hammett, just one of the most iconic guitar players of a time, is putting out a four-track EP that is an instrumental track. It is going to be called Portals. It is set to be released April 23rd, which is apparently World Record Store Day or National Record Store Day. I couldn't figure out if it was a worldwide celebration or just an American celebration. Either way, Record Store Day is April 23rd, and that is the day that this record is coming out. I'm very intrigued to see what Kirk Hammett has to offer without the rest of Metallica behind him. This could be fantastic, or it could be super lukewarm. We're going to find out on April 23rd. Next up, we have CMFT is back in the news. Corey MF Taylor, CMFT, the follow-up album is coming. Kind of. We have actually two sort of announcements having to do with the CMFT side project for Mr. Taylor from the Slipknots and the Stone Sours. And that is that first up, we have a B-sides. I almost want to say B-sides and quote unquote rarities, but he only has one album out and just came out last October. So that would be a little ridiculous. This is also a little ridiculous. It is not really a B-sides. It's a covers and acoustics album that is going to be covers that they've been working on since they were doing the sessions for that first CMFT record, and then also some acoustics of the songs that were on that original. The first single is going to be released this coming Friday, February 11th. The song is On the Dark Side by John Caffrey and the Beaver Brown Band. It is, the record itself is going to be coming out in on the 25th of February. And then Corey says once he's done with whatever it is that Slipknot is working on, that he would like to go into production on the proper follow-up to that CMFT record that again came out last October. So very interesting. If you dug the super bland radio rock that was the majority of that CMFT album, then you're probably very excited about this, but I can't get super excited about it. There was, I think, two tracks on there that I really, really liked. Everything else was like, yeah, I can see why he didn't do this as a Stone Sour record. So that is where we're standing with that. But staying in the Slipknot vein of things, we do have a really cool announcement about Jay Weinberg, current main drummer for the band Slipknot. Jay Weinberg was just Jay Weinberg was just named Metal Drummer of the Year by the first annual Drumeo Awards. You can find a link down in the description for all of the other drummers that were nominated for the other categories. And there are quite a few, but I mean, each subcategory is pretty large in and of itself. So congratulations are in order for Jay Weinberg. Now we move into tours for the music section. The tours subsection, we have two announcements. First up, we have Nine Inch Nails announcing that they are going to be going on tour in North America. They're going to be primarily supported by Ministry and Nitzer Ebb. The tour starts April 28th in Raleigh, North Carolina, and runs through September 24th in Cleveland, Ohio. Tickets on sale this Friday. Link in the description if you can get yours, because usually they sell pretty dang quick. That being said, our other tour that we're announcing, kind of, is the continuation of the Mastodon and Opeth tour. They are currently on tour in Europe together. This is the North American leg of that very same tour. It is going to be starting April 21st in Montreal, Canada. I believe that's Quebec. And then runs through May 11th in Riverside, California. Again, links can be found if you follow the link down, or tickets rather, can be found if you follow the link down in the description. Got those two backwards. All right, so now our new subsection is the suggestions. We do have one suggestion for music this week, and that is Gojira's new record, Fortitude. Absolutely, you should go listen to that. There is a reason why these men were nominated for a Grammy. I know Grammys don't really mean a whole lot, but at least we know that the mainstream is taking notice when something of superb quality is released, and that is what this Fortitude record is. It definitely deserves your attention. That's what we have for suggestions in the music section. Let's continue on down the road into the gaming and tech section, and this probably has one of my more excitable pieces of news for this episode. Let's start first, though, in the follow-ups and corrections section. So follow-up on Halo Infinite. We were supposed to start this week, according to some outlets, we were supposed to start this week today as I'm filming, so yesterday as you're watching or listening, with a new event, a new sub-event, I guess, in the Halo Infinite game. And that was supposed to be the Tactical Ops event, which there's a couple of rumors around this, so we'll get to that in the rumor mill. But yeah, Tactical Ops was supposed to start today. It didn't. It's not starting actually until March. Season 2 is still a few months out, so we will probably see the Fracture Tenrai event come back at least one more time, probably twice before the end of Season 1. So if you have yet to get your Yaorai suit of armor the way you want it, then you've got more time to do that. The Tactical Ops event will still be coming. It is still on the calendar. Just looks like it is going to be March 8th. And not February 8th. Our next follow-up has to do with Suicide Squad Kill the Justice League. This one also is a change in date. It has been moved back to 2023. No exact time window has been given aside from just sometime next year. Hopefully that's a good thing. If you have watched enough of that Hey What Happened series on YouTube, then you know that not always is a change in schedule a bad thing. So hopefully this is just going to give them time to polish up what they already have. And then our final piece of follow-up news is the piece that Gladiator Bricks over on the TikToks contributed to, or actually requested more like, and that is Fallout 5. He requested that we look into Fallout 5 and what the status is right now. And it is kind of what it has been since November when we last checked in on this. And that is not a whole lot going on because Bethesda actually has three pretty massive projects on their plate as it stands. So right now, they're dealing with Starfield, which is their Xbox exclusive title, and then Elder Scrolls 6, as well as that Indiana Jones game that we talked about a few months back. All three of these projects are very much in development, as well as whatever they're doing for maintenance, whatever that means, on Fallout 76. So very much Bethesda is not dormant right now, just Fallout kind of is. Okay, so our final piece of follow-up is Joe Rogan. So Rumble has jumped into the mix and they have offered something similar to what Spotify gave him. Not the same, it is very similar though. So Spotify offered Joe $100 million for somewhere between 4 and 5 years of exclusivity on their platform. Mostly exclusivity because he's still posting clips to YouTube. Either way, so $100 million for 4 years on Spotify. But theoretically, they could be in breach of contract because they're censoring him. They're requesting. They did say that Joe took down those 100 plus episodes over the weekend last week. But they are requesting that he do things to censor himself. Potentially, he's also censoring himself. But either way, there is something coming down from Spotify. So Rumble said, "Hey, we will give you $100 million for 4 years." And we're not going to censor you. We're going to let you take even all of the ones that you've taken down. We're going to let you put all of those episodes up on our platform as long as you sign exclusivity with us for 4 years. Now, the catch here is, even though those sound the same, they're not, because Rogan also has stock in Spotify. So he would have to have something similar in Rumble, which probably is not going to be the same deal. So whatever he brings in for subscriptions on Spotify, he gets a portion of that. And so likewise, Rumble would have to cut him something similar there. Those details have not yet been made public. It's a very evolving situation. We're not going to talk about all of the new people who have come out to support him or all of those who have come out against him, because that's just silly. And I said I didn't want to talk about that again. So yeah, that's where that stands. Let's move on, shall we, into proper news. And we have some really interesting techie kind of stuff for proper news. First thing is the really interesting, super exciting bit from NASA. NASA has announced that by the end of the decade, so before 2030, presumably, they are trying to put another manned mission to the moon. Up in space they're not competing. We as a country, as far as the space race is concerned, we are not competing with other countries. We are competing the government versus private enterprise. We have SpaceX, which is Elon Musk, and then Blue's the Amazon one. Jeff Bezos is Blue, whatever. Blue Beetle? No. That's where the space race is. So NASA has teamed up to a degree with Toyota, and they're going to be designing what they're calling the Lunar Cruiser. in kind of homage to the land cruiser that they make already. So very interesting. This lunar cruiser is going to be the first manable space or manable vehicle on the moon that is sealed, so they'll be able to breathe without being in their suits, as well as something that the astronauts themselves will control, aside from what we got last time we went to the moon, which was they had to be in their suits, or it's been something that has only been controllable by NASA here on Earth. So very interesting there, super exciting. There's a whole giant blurb that I was planning on reading, but we're not going to read that. It's going to be a long enough episode. So yeah, super exciting. We will be keeping tabs here as that space race ramps up, because if that's not nerdy news, I don't know what is. Our next piece has to do with Pokemon. Nintendo, actually, rather more specifically, has released a new streaming platform that is streaming free-to-play music, so you can put in your gaming stream some free music from Nintendo that is based on Pokemon music. It is actual Pokemon music. It is their sound library. You can find the link to it down in the description below. That is kind of gigantic, because Nintendo is notorious for not wanting people to stream their games for whatever reason, and so this is kind of a huge step in the right direction. That is what we have for news. Suggestions here in the gaming and tech section. Really just happy Elden Ring Day. If you're not playing that, then you're hopefully playing Halo or Splitgate, which we talked about in the last episode. So that's what we've got there for suggestions. Let's talk ever so briefly about comic books and books. I have one correction from the last episode. In the suggestions subsection of comic books, I said Dragonfly and Dragonfly Man. I believe that is one title for those comic books, though the compiled trade for those is called Wrong Earth. I apologize. I don't know where my brain went when I was writing that suggestion down, but Wrong Earth is probably going to be an easier way to find that. Either way, definitely worth a read. Let's get into the news. So our first piece is, our only piece rather, is Spider-Man 2099. New book has been announced from Marvel. It's called Exodus-Alpha, written by Steve Orlando. We have art from Paul Fry, David Watcher, Marco Castillo, Z. Carlos, Alessandro Mercola, and Kim Jacinto, all the creative team for this book. This time, we're also going to be seeing a 2099 version of Loki, as well as the Winter Soldier, with some very interesting additions to the X-Men team in the 2099 lineup. So they are really gearing up these X-Men stories for the future of the comic books, which means we hopefully are going to be seeing them in the movie section. We'll talk about that when it happens, though. So real quick, suggestion for the comic books section is Death of the Family, DC's Death of the Family, not In the Family, Death of the Family. We're working our way back to In the Family. Death of the Family by Scott Snyder. One of my favorite books in the Batman lore from the last 15 years or so. I really, really dug it. I think his Joker needed a little bit of work, because, you know, Joker's more than just one note, but still pretty solid read. Go check that one out. That's what we have for the comic book section. One more quick aside, nerds. We do have an algorithm to appease. So if you have not already, please take the time to like the episode, however that happens on whichever platform you are on. That's all I'm really asking. Just a real quick click down there on that thumb, depending on, again, where you're at. On Rumble, it's something else. On YouTube, that's what it is, a thumbs up. On Facebook, it's a thumbs up. But, you know, wherever else you are, whatever the method of letting the algorithm know that this is a video you like, then go ahead and do that. And then we have more news to talk about in this episode. Now we're moving into TV streaming. This is probably the biggest section of the entire thing, mostly because we have so many follow-ups. So let's start there. Goosebumps, the series that we talked about potentially happening over a year ago, is now actually happening. The IP is getting a series on Disney Plus. Just the first season has been officially ordered by Disney Plus. This is going to be a little bit different from the 90s version of this show, which was an anthology series. This is going to be one story throughout, so it's going to tell a narrative from the beginning to the end of the series. Or of the season, rather. Yeah, it's finally rolling forward. So let's move right along. Next, we're talking about the CW. We got some pilots ordered, not actual full series just yet, but we do have pilots ordered for the Winchester's prequel series to Supernatural, as well as Gotham Knights, not to be confused with the Gotham Knights game that is going to be happening. This one's interesting. This does still deal with the death of Batman, but it deals with what is being billed as Batman's adopted son. So which version of Robin that is, we won't know until the pilot launches. But the Batman's adoptive son teaming up with the children of the Rogues Gallery to clear their names because they're being accused of killing Batman. So, interesting premise. We'll see if they can pull that off because the CW is dying, but you know, that is what it is. So next follow-up, we have X-Men 97. We do have confirmation now that it will pick up from the end of the original animated cartoon. We also have announcements for voice casting. We have Cal Dodd, Lenore Zahn, George Buza, Allison Seeley-Smith, Chris Potter, Catherine Disher, Adrian Hugh, and Christopher Britton all reprising their vocal roles in the series. So these were the things that we were worried about. Our worries are being relieved, as it were. So very, very exciting news there. And then we have one real quick follow-up on the Foundation series over on Apple Plus. Season 2 is happening, so catch up on Foundation, won't you? And then let's get into trailers. We have the Boys spin-off animated series gave us our first trailer, kind of, I think. Diabolical is the name of the series. You can find the link down in the description. It's weird. And not in like the way you would expect from The Boys as far as the live action series goes. Just weird on its own. Yeah, you'll see what I'm talking about. So our next trailer is also kind of not really a trailer. It's just the first few minutes of the next season of The Orville, which we've been waiting a few years for at this point. It also kind of got pushed back. We're now expecting it to come out in June, so June 2nd, when originally it was announced as coming out March 10th. So not the biggest pushback, because it is still this year, but it is pushed back. So, and then our final trailer to talk about is Marvelous Miss Maisel season 4 trailer finally launched. We have February 18th is when this series is going to be coming back to Amazon Prime, and I cannot wait because it is one of my favorite Prime series. Let's move on, shall we? So in news, a series that we haven't talked about previously, but is now getting a second season, is Reacher. We haven't talked about it because it's only been active on Prime for, I think, like maybe a week. So a little early in the life cycle of this new Reacher series. If you don't know, this is the third actor to play Jack Reacher. Originally Tom Cruise and then John Krasinski. And now the guy's name escapes me. I apologize. Alan Ritchson, who you will recognize as Aquaman from Smallville, also Hawk from Titans, is now playing Jack Reacher. Really interesting that these new series, this and then Yellowstone and 1883, have this kind of like conservative values kind of thing going, and they're the ones that are doing the best. Yeah, maybe that's a thing to take note of, maybe. I don't know, but it is what it is. So we're moving on. Next piece has to do with a new series that's been announced, Tales of the Walking Dead. We have an anthological series coming out in the Walking Dead universe. This is probably to fill the gap between the end of season 10 or 11. I can't remember. We're in season 11, right? This is the final season. So season 11, between the end of season 11 and then the Carol Darryl show that is going to be happening post season 11, which the season finale of season 11 is supposed to be a backdoor pilot for. So that could be interesting. Interesting as well. The so far we are in casting stage for the Tales of the Walking Dead, and so far we have cast Terry Crews, Poppy Liu, Parker Posey, Anthony Edwards, and Julian Bell. All potentially for maybe the same episode, maybe different episodes. Each of them are going to be starring in their own episode of this anthology series. We won't know because they haven't told us yet. So yeah, we'll keep tabs on that because great, great universe to live in, that Walking Dead universe. And then that brings us to suggestions for the TV streaming section. We have Marvelous Miss Maisel and The Orville. If you have not caught up on those, I highly, highly suggest you do that because both of those series are fantastic in their own right. Honestly, some of the best freaking television around are those two series. And if you have caught up on those, then by all means finish Peacemaker on HBO Max because also quality stuff. I just love John Cena as Peacemaker, and these seven episodes are perfect. So freaking good. Anyway, moving right along. Real quick, before we go any further, nerds, we do a live version of this show at the end of every week that is then followed by some gaming, a stream of things and stuff. Right now I'm on a Halo kick, so we're probably going to be playing some Halo this week. Probably also going to be trying a little bit of Splitgate just because I'm pretty sure I am comfortable where we are on Halo. Either way, don't forget to check it out on the YouTube channel, youtube.com/generallynerdy. Every Friday, round about 7 or 8 p.m. Mountain Standard Time. Really, it just depends on what my day job schedule looks like. Either way, that is where we do the things and the stuff. And now, back to the episode. Now we are into the movies section. Movies is short, so let's knock this bad boy out. Follow-ups in the movies section, we have a follow-up on Fight Club. The Chinese version of Fight Club has been restored to what we saw in theaters here in the States. There was some backlash. Chuck Palahniuk was like, I don't understand the backlash. My books have been banned all over my home country of America for ages at this point. So when China does it, all of a sudden it's bad. I don't get it. Also of note, I think we talked about this when we talked about it originally, but the Chinese ending is kind of a little bit more accurate to the book in certain ways. So maybe not the police catching everyone part, but definitely what they did to Jack. Yeah, that's more accurate to the book version than the actual movie. So whatever. Restored. So if you're in China, you can watch the actual Fight Club movie. We have news. First, another follow-up. So we'll get to that one to get that one out of the way. And that is Scream has announced that there is going to be another Scream movie. So we're going to have 6 Scream movies before the end of everything and potentially more. But right now we're only signed up for 6. Officially happening. And then my favorite piece of news for the movie section is Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde starring Eddie Izzard. Eddie Izzard is probably one of my favorite comedians of all time, honestly. And for those that don't know, they, I think is preferred pronouns there, have come out as trans forever ago. If you didn't know Eddie Izzard was trans, you weren't paying attention because he does most of his stand-ups as a woman. So I apologize, I'm misgendering, whatever. So the reason this is significant to the Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde story is it's going to be a trans version of the story. So Dr. Jekyll is going to be female, so Eddie as female, and then Mr. Hyde is going to be male, so Eddie as male. That's, I mean, how great of a opportunity for a great actor, great comedian. Oh my, I'm super, super excited for this one. Not gonna lie, I think it's gonna be great just because Eddie Izzard is great. That is all we have for this section, except for suggestions. So, movie suggestions celebrating the Fight Club change in China. Go watch Fight Club because it's probably the best movie ever made. And if you want to have that conversation because you don't agree with me, let's have that in the comments. But yeah, Fight Club, fantastic movie. If you haven't watched it for a while, it's worth it. Go do that. Let's move on into Rumor Mill. So we do have a confirmation of a rumor that we honestly didn't really talk about before. That confirmation is for Halo Infinite. There was a leak for this weekend, this coming weekend, starting February 11th. There is going to be a big tournament, so there are going to be Twitch drops. Those Twitch drops leaked between last episode and this episode, and just this morning, as I was getting ready to film, they got confirmed. So, yeah, confirmed Halo Infinite Twitch drops. If you are looking for this stuff, I mean, I'm kind of not super excited about all of it, but some of those weapon skins, pretty awesome. All right, so rumors, and then we have, we're not giving percentages to these rumors, so we're just going to hit these real quick. Possible trailers that we might be seeing this weekend during the Super Bowl. We have Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness. Makes sense. Lightyear, this one just happened, honestly. They just gave us what was supposed to theoretically come out this weekend, so that's already confirmed as well. And then we have Moon Knight might be dropping a second trailer during the Super Bowl, which would also make sense. So let's get into the actual rumors that we need to give percentages to. By this point, you're probably wondering why I haven't brought up Madam Web. Well, we're bringing Madam Web up now here in the Rumor Mill because none of the news that we've been receiving over the last few days, last week roughly, has been officially announced. It is all still speculation. It's all still rumor. It's all still quote unquote leaks. So what am I talking about? If you haven't heard, Madam Web is supposed to be the next Sony Spider-less universe movie that goes into production. Though I think Spider-Woman probably is going to beat it to the punch, but everyone is losing their mind about Madam Web because supposedly Dakota Johnson is now in talks to play the titular character. So some people who haven't read comic books are a little up in arms because Dakota Johnson isn't really old, and all they've seen of Madam Web is that she's a very old character. So that's actually a very small subsection of the people who are upset about this announcement. The other main subsect of people is Dakota Johnson isn't blind. There are other blind actresses out there. So that should be, well, if all of those other blind actresses had the same pull or the same ability as Dakota Johnson, not saying she's a great actress, but like, I mean, let's be real here. Hollywood is about making money, so you gotta put a big name in a big role, right? That is the way of business, and business is good right now for Spider-Man and the, or for Sony and the Spider-less universe. So, this is all very much rumor, but we have some pretty solid sources reporting on it as it is going to be a thing. So we are giving this, all of this together, that A, Madam Web is going to be a movie that Sony does, and B, that Dakota Johnson, even the rumor doesn't say that Dakota Johnson is going to be Madam Web. It just says that she is in discussions to possibly play Madam Web. So that, yeah, 80% that those two things are factual. Then we're switching over to the CW ever so briefly for Booster Gold rumor. The Flash is supposed to have a Booster Gold in season 7. Donald Faison has recently announced that he is going to be playing a secret character in season 7. So the rumor is that was eventually going to follow those two announcements. Donald Faison is going to be Booster Gold. I don't see why not. They've done plenty of other things in this vein in the Arrowverse, especially on Flash. Three very large characters in the Flash mythos have been race swapped, so why wouldn't they do that to Booster Gold as well? Sure, I'm giving this one 70% just because it is pretty predominant, though, again, not a whole lot of really solid leakers are saying this. We have the current Doctor Strange Multiverse of Madness rumors kicking about now too. This round of rumors for these new cameos, we're talking about Vin Diesel's version of Black Bolt is said to be making a cameo in the movie, as well as Professor X as played by Patrick Stewart. So the Patrick Stewart rumor we've addressed previously, this is just a new source, 75% likely for Patrick Stewart. I'm going to go 50-50 on Vin Diesel, about 50%. We're starting in the middle because we don't know which way it's headed, because this is the first we've heard about this cameo, and it's kind of a 50-50 kind of source too. So yeah, we're going right in the middle because we don't know which way this one's headed just yet. Then we have a Call of Duty rumor. This is actually a movie rumor, not a game rumor. Call of Duty is supposedly going to be the video game movie that The Rock has alluded to recently as being his next project. So Mortal Kombat fans, maybe it's a sigh of relief that he's not going to be Shao Kahn. Maybe you're upset that he's not going to be Shao Kahn. Let's talk about that. The Rock as Shao Kahn. I mean, it's still potentially possible because we don't know what Mortal Kombat 2 is going to bring, but let's talk about The Rock as Shao Kahn down in the comments, shall we? This rumor does come from a pretty solid leaker. So again, we're going to go 60%. It is only one source that is saying that that is what it is, but it's one that has a pretty good track record. So we're going 60% on this one. Next is a Star Wars rumor, Andor, the series that is coming to Disney Plus that they are currently working on. That is, honestly, they're currently in post-production, I believe, so working on all the special effects and such. We will be seeing Andor soon. I believe it is actually this year, by fall, if I'm not mistaken. Either way, the rumor around this is that we are going to be getting a second season. Stellan Skarsgård, who is in the series, recently said in an interview that he has Dune 2 to film next, and then straight from there, he's going into the next season of Andor. Which is very strange, because everyone assumed this was going to be a one-off season, because everyone dies in the Rogue One movie that it's leading up to. So presumably this implies that it's going to be further back in time than we initially anticipated, which is kind of cool. But because this is coming from Stellan Skarsgård, who is again in the series, we're giving this one a 75% likelihood. I didn't give it higher than that because actors don't always know this far in advance what their project is going to be two projects out. So he could have been confused. I don't think that's the case. I do think that we are going to be getting a second season, which is why it's so high, but either way, 75%. And then we have an actual gaming rumor, and this has to do with the Batman Arkham series. Supposedly, according to a leak given to us by a wonderful European online store, the Arkham Collection, which is going to be the Rocksteady trilogy of Batman games, not Arkham Origins, but the Arkham Asylum, Arkham City, and Arkham Knight, those three games are going to be released in a bundle for the Nintendo Switch. And the rumor is specific in saying that it's going to be coming out in August. I'm giving this one an 80% chance. Every time a leak like this happens and I don't go at least this high, I kind of end up eating crow. So that's the direction we're going here. 80% likely that we will be seeing the Arkham Collection on the Switch. And then we have more news and rumors. If you want to catch up, you're falling behind, then one of the two boxes to the side of my face should help you out there on the YouTubes. If you're on the audio, I apologize. Just go through the archives or go to the Patreon, patreon.com/generallynerdy to find it there. Don't forget to like, subscribe, do the things. Thank you very much, nerds. Before we head out, always, always remember that if it's generally nerdy, it's probably here.